So this paper is the first in a series of six consensus statements from the Society for Perioperative Assessment and Quality Improvement, also known as SPAQI, SPACI. The Society states that the medication management is a crucial element of preoperative assessment, optimization, and risk reduction. At the moment, there's no evidence-based guidelines for best practice of perioperative medication management for most medications. And the lack of guidelines for preoperative dosing of opioid and non-opioid pain medication can lead to suboptimal preoperative and perioperative pain control. So basically, the purpose of this paper is to provide a framework for preoperative physicians and nurses like anesthesiologists, primary care physicians, surgeons, internal medicine physicians working in preoperative clinics to provide consistent best care for their patients. My name is Michael O'Rourke. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Anesthesiology and Perioperative Medicine at Loyola University Chicago. And I'm also the medical director of our preoperative clinic. And also I'm an anesthesiologist at the Edward Hines Jr. Veteran Affairs Hospital. The title of the paper is Preoperative Management of Opioid and Non-Opioid Analgesics, Society for Perioperative Assessment and Quality Improvement Consensus Statement, which will be published in the May 2021 issue of Mayo Clinic Proceedings. The paper is a consensus statement, which was put together by a group of experts. Those experts were in fields such as anesthesiology, pain management, internal medicine, preoperative assessment, and addiction medicine. And basically, the SPACI group asked that group of experts to come up with consensus guidelines for pain medications. We divided the pain medications into six groups: opioid agonists, opioid antagonists, combined opioid agonists and antagonists, acetaminophen, muscle relaxants, and headache pain medication like triptans. Basically, the group used a modified Delphi method to establish consensus for preoperative dosing of those medications. You can find in the paper, there's a table with specific medication classes, the specific recommendation for the day of surgery for those individual medications, and additional considerations like drug-drug interactions. Millions of people have surgery every day, and perhaps more than 20% of those individuals take preoperative opioid and non-opioid pain medications. It's known that increased preoperative pain can lead to increased postoperative pain levels, as well as increased opioid use after six months after surgery. Obviously, increased postoperative pain and increased opioid use after surgery are suboptimal. So it's important to have optimal preoperative dosing of opioid and non-opioid pain medications in order to have optimal preoperative pain control. So we hope that in a real way, this paper can improve a patient's perioperative experience by optimizing preoperative pain medication dosing. We hope that in terms of patient care, this paper can provide improved and more consistent preoperative pain control for patients, especially for pain medications which are less common or less familiar to those writing the preoperative medication instructions. Because this is a consensus statement, the next step is implementation. We hope that this consensus statement and the recommendations found within it will be widely adopted to improve patient care. So this is the first in a series of six consensus statements from the Society for Perioperative Assessment and Quality Improvement, SPACI. Medication management is a crucial element of preoperative assessment, optimization, and risk reduction. And our hope is that this particular statement on preoperative dosing of opioids and non-opioid pain medications can be implemented in a meaningful way by a wide variety of practitioners to optimize patient care in the perioperative setting.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of our website valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you'll find access to information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.org. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.